who stand.
But with you there is forgiveness, therefore you are feared.
Since we are gathered to hear God's word, call upon him in prayer and praise, and receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fellowship of this altar, let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ, and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake, forgives you all your sins. As a called and obedient servant of Christ, and by his authority, I, therefore, forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
gracious Father, your blessed Son came down from heaven to be the true bread that gives life to the world. Grant that Christ, the bread of life, may live in us and we in him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. The Old Testament reading for the 11th Sunday after Pentecost is from 1 Kings chapter 19, beginning at verse 1. Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah, saying, "So may the gods do to me and more also, if I do not make your life as the life of one of them by this time tomorrow." Then he was afraid, and he arose and ran for his life, and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, and came and sat down under a broom tree. And he asked that he might die, saying, "It is enough now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my father's." And he lay down and slept under a broom tree. And behold, an angel touched him and said to him, "Arise and eat." And he looked, and behold, there was at his head a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. And he ate and drank and lay down again. And the angel looked, and again a second time, and said, "Arise."
grace, mercy, and peace be with you. The text is from Psalm 34, verse 8. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Psalm 34 is part of our reading for today. And of course, we will dwell on our gospel reading. But I thought to bring this topic about taste and see that the Lord is good. That's what I want to remember. Taste and see that the Lord is good. That's according to Psalm 34, verse 8. So we just heard in our reading, Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. Whoever eats of me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will not thirst." That is not just a statement. Promises. Promise. Whoever is of me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will not thirst. Thank you, Jesus. We just heard also the Old Testament reading about Elijah, the man of God, lived in a troubled life, just as we do. And the enemy pursued him. They found he made a decree that when I see you, when I touch you, you will never be the same. And so he runs. And he's hiding and running. And he came to Mount Horeb, also known as Mount Sinai. There, the Lord, he heard the voice of the Lord speak to him. They found he was fed on his way. The angels of the Lord fed him. And the Lord, Elijah, complained to God. See, what's happening to me? There's no one left. I am the only one standing. And they are going to kill me. I complain to God. But it seems that God is not interested in the complaining. God is interested in doing the work. And God tells him to go back, go to work. Because the glory is not in the complaining, the glory is in the work. For the past few weeks, and maybe even next week, we'll be hearing about dinner. Bread, after bread, feed on me. And Jesus is saying today again, I am that bread of life. That whoever eats of me will not go hungry. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Well, all this sounds so perfect on paper. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Until something goes wrong. hallelujah and rejoice and believe in the Lord, our God, who made heaven and earth. Yes, we say that. But what happens if something goes wrong, not what we expected? Wait until 9/11 happens and everything changes. Praise God. Praise God. Or wait until a little child is diagnosed with some disease and our faith vanishes. Will God still be the God? Will he not be the son of Mary? That son of Mary and Joseph around here calls himself bread of life from heaven. Son of Mary. You know, in the Bible days, the Jews, if they call you by your mother's name, that's not good. Son of Mary. That's not good. That's derogatory. So, in other words, they saw Jesus as being nothing. He's just another man passing around, calling himself God of God in heaven. But thank God, he gives us the Spirit to remind us that he is the bread of life. There were times that I, myself, doubted that God really exists. And there will be times. And I apologize for being the bearer of the bad news. If you never experience anything difficult, you will experience it. And those of you who experience already, thank God for you. I still believe in him. Because when the going gets tough and you hear that grandpa is diagnosed with Alzheimer's, everything changes. Sometimes we forget about church. Is God really real? But I'm also here to testify that God is real. Taste and see that the Lord is good. And the word taste that's translated means experience. Experience the goodness of God. Experience the goodness of God. And how do you experience that? Of course, when you go through this life, and in a day-to-day life, and you see that your hope is almost gone, and the Lord shows up, you experience that. And God has a way of showing up all the time. All the time, he shows up. He showed up for Elijah at Mount Horeb. It's the same mountain that God made covenant with the Israelites, with the children of Israel, the same mountain. That God gave the Ten Commandments. It's the same mountain. And Horeb means God's mountain. You and I this morning are before God's mountain. And we again to hear him speak to us and to go into the world. That trouble was, I know Monday to Saturday we'll go through lots of things, and it's tough out there. It's tough. Do we complain and forget God? But God is so good. God is good. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Experience God and see that He's very, very good. He's a good God. He never, never leaves us. Never. He made a promise in Matthew. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. I will never leave you. I will be with you even unto the end of time. Even unto the end of our time here. Here and now. This time. I know the church goes through a lot these days. A lot is happening. Maybe personally also. But God will not let you perish. He will all be with you. And this morning, also, a farewell ceremony for Sister Noel. This is the day, I guess, we didn't want to come, right? Is that the day we're waiting for? No. No. No, 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 no. But may the Lord go with you and be with you. May you find him at a mountain on earth. In his kingdom, he's always with us, and he will always be with you. Our God is good. I have a first name, and I'm sure you have a first name. And that's why you're still here. That's why you still call him. You still believe him. I know the Jews grumbled. Who is this? Well, they were just fed not too long ago, and Jesus is speaking to them, and still not believing God. And that's the old man that is in us. You talk about him, the old man, the old self. That grumbled God in us. Put away that old man and put on a new man. The new man is in Jesus Christ, our Lord. As we hear, we call on him, may he always remind us that he is our God. May we never forget that he is able to carry us and lead us through all of life's challenges. I don't care what it is. That when we fall, we get up because he is there for us. May you experience the goodness of God. May you experience God. May you taste him and know that he's good. He's sweeter than McDonald's. Burger King. God is sweeter. He gives us new life. He gives us life eternal. And that anyone that's like him, so that we all will have eternal life. That anybody who believes in him will not die, he says, will have eternal life. For may the God who is able to keep you from falling, keep you this day and always. Amen.
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 Come on in, come on in. Slide over, Noel. There you go.
So, Noel, this is not a day I was looking for. But I can't have it. Beloved in the Lord, Noel is departing this new church of the way. At this time of farewell and Godspeed, let us hear the word of the Lord from Philippians chapter 1.
I thank my God in all my remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine, for you all making my prayer with joy. Because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, and I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to feel this way about you all, because I hold you in my heart, for you are all partakers with me of grace, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I yearn for you all with the affection of Christ Jesus.
Lord God, Heavenly Father, we give thanks for all the blessings you have bestowed on this congregation through the faithful service of Noel. Grant that our example of faithful devotion to your word and loving service to others may, by your grace, be a blessing and encouragement to many. May your mercy support and strengthen her at school and grant her your peace and blessedness now and forever. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
The Almighty God, most merciful God, the Father and Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and bless and strengthen you both now and forever.
Amen.
We rise for prayer. The eyes of all look to you, O Lord. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. Incline now your ears to hear us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for her musical service to this congregation, bless Noel as she departs Lutheran Church of the Way for studies abroad. Give her opportunities to use her gifts. Guide her in your ways and keep your hand of protection on her. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Preserve the pure proclamation of the gospel throughout all the world. Thwart all false teaching and the lies of Satan, and draw many to yourself through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Cause our congregation and all congregations in our circuit, district, and the synod to flourish and thrive. Make them strong witnesses to their confession of faith, eager to show mercy on account of your steadfast mercy. Knit us together in unity of doctrine and love for our neighbors. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give strength and courage to all pastors and all those who assist them, especially those suffering from conflict, burnout, or depression. By the example of Elijah and all who have gone before them, bring them comfort through the forgiveness of sins and the promise of everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all families and homes, especially the Gordon, Hacker, and Harris families, that one generation may tell to the next the wonderful works of God in Christ. Give joy and celebration to Paul, celebrating a birthday this week. Give blessing and provision to the community of Quincy. that they may know you, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Hear our prayers for our nation. Cause us to live in harmony and justice with one another, and free our citizens from want, suffering, danger, and fear. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Show kindness to the sick and in need, especially Jean, Walt, Reese, Esme, Claudette, Dick, Katerina, John, Mason, Jesse, Amy, Ingo, Pat, Sandy, Reagan, President Yaden, Stanley, Bob, Claire, Pastor Dickerhoff and his family, and all afflicted with COVID. Never let them be in doubt that you hear their prayers. Relieve all pain and provide for those who suffer from any kind of hardship. Lord, in your mercy, bless those who commune this day, that reconciled to each other in Christ's body and blood, they may rejoice to receive your forgiveness through this precious gift. Be strengthened in times of doubt and be nourished in body and soul. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father of our risen, ascended, and glorified Lord, who has promised that those who believe in Christ is the true and living bread will never hunger nor thirst. By your Holy Spirit, keep us steadfast in faith. Give us grace to live out our baptismal life in repentance and forgiveness, and keep our eyes ever focused on a life that never ends, knowing that you will raise us up on the last day through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Lord, peace to you.
Shall we stand? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Everlasting God, for the countless blessings you so freely bestow on us and all creation. Above all, we give thanks for your boundless love shown to us when you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh and laid on him our sin, giving him unto death that we might not die eternally, because he is now risen from the dead and lives and reigns to all eternity. All who believe in him will overcome sin and death and will rise again to the new life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of heaven.
By our second Adam, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and made his cross a life-giving tree for all who trust in him. We give you thanks for the redemption you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Grant us your Holy Spirit that we may faithfully eat and drink of the fruits of his cross and receive the blessings of forgiveness, life, and salvation that come to us in his body and blood. Hear us as we pray in his name and as he has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the same way also, he took a cup after supper. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, given for you. This do as often as you do in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Thank you.
this body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in body and soul to life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen.
Blood of Christ, shed for the forgiveness of your sins. Take and drink the true blood of Christ, shed for the forgiveness of your sins.
Thank you.
O God the Father, the fountain and source of all goodness, who in loving kindness sent your only begotten Son into the flesh, we thank you that for his sake you have given us pardon and peace in this sacrament, and we ask you not to forsake your children, but always to rule our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, that we may be enabled constantly to serve you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with
Lord, lift up his face towards you and give you peace. Now, amen.
Amen.
I just have one announcement. I did talk to Pastor Jake Dickelhoff late this week. He was passing into the lower 48 into Montana, and then he'll be going on to Minnesota. It's been a difficult journey for him. He's had problems with the movers and all kinds of things, but The man is impressive. He keeps such an upbeat and jovial attitude. It was just wonderful to talk to him. So I told him we're all waiting for him, and we'll do whatever we can to help him in this journey. Thank you.
I guess it's my turn. First of all, I do bring greetings from Pastor Schiffel. As you know, he was in the hospital a couple weeks ago. He is out of the hospital. He is in good spirits. He's doing well. He was out in the Love Eye the other night having dinner with his daughter and wife. And he does thank you for your prayers and concerns. And he looks forward to worshiping with us soon. This time, I have been asked to well to come up. She knows it's coming. So, you know, I think, Pastor, you have a very good segue into this, because when we hear those words, "Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good," I don't believe there's anyone in this room that doubts that we have tasted and seen the goodness of God through the ministry of this young woman. So when I arrived here 5 years ago as Claudia's long-term sub, you know, I got here, and then there's this little girl who comes up and says, "Hey, by the way, you know, I play the violin, and if you're ever going to play, I'm happy to do it." And I'm thinking, "Oh, man. Really? We'll figure it out." And so, maybe the first time they said, "Well, thank you, we'll think about it, and we'll figure it out." But obviously, as time progressed and as my tenure here continued, I was blessed very much by your ministry and your gifts and your talents. One of the joys of ministry is that our hope and our goal as a church is to export talent. Now, this congregation is getting really good about exporting musicians. And continue to send them further and further. So, by the way, I like staying, so think about that. We're getting really good at that. But our hope and our prayer for you, Noel, is when you take off and you head off to the Netherlands for, well, pretty similar, gray, cloudy skies, maybe a little more rain, that you remember where you come from and who God has created you. And that is, one, first of all, a child of God, loved by this congregation, and loved by a father who, not only this father, who is always back there, but a heavenly father. And know that you have been gifted with an incredible gift. And so, remember these words from Matthew, in the same way, so let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. You have been a light to this congregation. You have been a light to many in this community, and I know at school and other places. And so, do you realize how bad you're making me look when you leave? You know, and then I always say she makes me sound better. But the truth is, when the pandemic came, she Noelle got nothing coming in sometimes 2-3 times a week to come in and record. And then put up with me having to re-record again. And through these last couple of years, we've seen not only a growth in your gifts here, but also the ministry that you have. And don't forget that you do have a ministry here in this congregation. And as we export you, continue to use those gifts. And so on behalf of this congregation, we have a small gift for you. Now, one thing I have thought about when we think about tasting and seeing, you're also well known for cakes. I almost had you make your own. For our own, you know. We thought we should, you know, get our money's worth one last time, but instead, we do have cake, and we've got refreshments, but also a gift from this congregation. And so, thank you so much for your gifts, your ministry to this congregation, to these people, and we are here.
Thank you.
day and the opportunity that you give us to gather within these walls and to send off this young child of God that you have placed in our midst and in our care. And Father, if we release her to school and release her to your good graces, Lord, continue to provide her opportunities to use her gifts, but Father, keep her safe, keep her healthy, continue to grow her in her faith, that she may return here at Christmas and other holidays so she can come home. And Father, continue to remind her that she never walks alone. Continue to bless this congregation as we take new steps forward in our music ministry without Noelle. But Lord, we just thank you for the blessing that you've given us all these years through, in and through her. Keep her safe, keep her healthy. We love her. Amen.
Amen.
All right, so Noelle, do you have any last parting words? Put you on the spot, you guys can have a seat.
Bye.
She's not good at departing work, so here's the deal. Even better, let's eat cake.